Am I late? I'm so sorry. I worked a late shift. I know I'm cutting it close, but please, please, I really need this interview.
Okay, first relax and step away from my desk.
I'm sorry. I was rushing to get here, and then I was on the bus, and all these people in my way.
What is that smell?
Oh, that would be me. I'm a fry cook.
Okay, save it.
I'm here for the internship interview.
Sign in here, Ms.
Ms. Cooper. Okay. Can you please direct me to the
bathroom? Past the elevator to the right.
Great, thanks.
Nyasha Pierce?
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Calvin French. What's your name?
McKenzie Cooper.
Nice entrance there, Miss Cooper. You clean up pretty well.
Thank you. I've been having a crazy day.
Whew. Yeah, I can tell.
I've been up all night working the graveyard shift, and then after this interview, I have a world history final.
Wow, sounds hard. Mm-hmm. You go to school around here? You live here?
Yeah, I'm from here. I go to Howard.
Okay. That's a nice little school.
Are you from this area?
Oh, goodness, no. Rhode Island. Yeah, I go to Brown University.
Great school.
So, are you ready for this leadership interview?
I think so. I mean, I've been trying all week to figure out how to sell my leadership skills, but I'm drawing a blank.
Well, if you ask me, leadership, it's all about academic achievement. I mean, that's what most of these institutions want anyway. Take me, for instance. I've got a 4.0 GPA. I've won every academic award there is at Brown. I think I'm a shoo-in.
Wow, a 4.0 GPA?
Yeah, so as long as you got an exceptional GPA, you're fine.
I don't, but I'm sure everybody here can't possibly have a 4.0.
Actually, I've been making the rounds and, well, let's just say everyone in here is pretty darn close. Oh yeah, even that guy. I heard he has a 4.2 GPA. I didn't even know that was possible.
Well, what am I gonna tell the interviewers? I only have a 3.0 GPA.
Calvin French, you're next.
Don't worry about it, you do fine. Just tell them about your job at the fast food place. That should count for something, right? Well, good luck. You must be Sandra.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
What are you doing?
I just can't do this right now.
Well, one last we have to worry about.
You're out of luck. This is the slowest elevator in DC. What's your name?
McKenzie Cooper.
McKenzie Cooper. I know that name. I reviewed your program application. Aren't you here for the Federal Leadership Internship Program interview?
I was, but I don't think I qualify.
Qualify? What do you mean qualify? You were selected for an interview. I think you qualify.
Yeah, but the other students have a higher GPA than I do, and I just don't think I'm leadership material.
I see.
I mean, a leader does well in school and is prepared and has time for everything.
Well, not exactly. A true leader is someone who sets the example and motivates others to follow them. A leader also takes the initiative, earns the confidence of others, and assumes a high level of responsibility.
That makes sense, but I don't know if that's me.
Do you have a copy of your application?
Yeah, but I don't know what that'll...
Now, let's see. It says here you were elected vice president of your school's National Society of Black Engineers chapter.
Yeah, but it's not like I was president of NSB. Now that guy would be a perfect candidate.
Oh, well, there's more. You also serve as a lab prep technician for all the labs on campus, and that's just at school. You also do a lot in the community.
But is that really leadership?
Yeah, it is. And there's even more here. You organize drug awareness campaigns for local high schools, and you tutor elementary students, and on top of that—
There's more?
You're a senior fry chef at your job, right? So you're responsible for training employees and managing inventory. In my opinion, these are all great examples of leadership.
Yeah, but The other students have a higher GPA than I do.
McKenzie, don't sell yourself short. A good GPA doesn't tell the complete story of a student. In fact, it doesn't say anything about a person's leadership qualities. This gives a better indication of who you are. McKenzie, you proved it on paper. I'll prove it in person. A leader would walk through that door, McKenzie. What did you think of the last candidate?
Ideal.
Miss Cooper, I'm glad that you walked through that door.